thankful for our friend. We are so thankful for Justin and that they are willing to spend the rest of their lives together, Lord. We thank you for today and all the days that are to come. We ask that you be with them on the good days and the hard days. And we ask that you be with them and have them be fruitful and multiply. As soon as possible. And just be present with us today, Lord, even with the people that aren't with us. But they're here in our hearts.
You're causing tear wells, Hannah.
We love you so much, and we are so thankful for this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
On behalf of Jordan and Justin, it is my privilege to say a personal word of greeting and welcome. You are special in their hearts and in their lives, and they're honored that you have made the effort to be here to share in this tremendous time of covenant making. It's their desire that you enter into the joy and beauty and reverence of the following moments. With that in mind, let's pray. Lord, we thank you so much for today. Lord, as we prayed last night, we acknowledge there are so many days, months, years, decades that led us to today. So many relationships, so many mentors, aunts, uncles, friends. Lord, we thank you. We honor them. We thank you so much for the people that are represented here. Lord, we thank you for those that were not able to make it. Lord, we lift up those that are on that side of heaven. Lord, that these two would not be who they are without their investment. So we thank you for all of it. Lord, we love you. We thank you for today and what it can mean. Lord, we ask for a supernatural ability, just like we did last night, to take in these moments. This goes by so quickly. Lord, help us retain it. Help us be aware. Lord, help us not miss what you have for us. Lord, this is too special to rush through it. Lord, we love you. In your son's name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Now, who has the honor of giving away this incredibly beautiful bride?
Her mother and I.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well done. Trying to hand off. I'm going to put his hand in Justin's. And Justin, perfect, guys. You guys look incredible. Today you're presenting yourselves to declare your intention of uniting your lives honorably and voluntarily for the service of God and man. You're making a double dedication, one to each other, in a lasting and indivisible union that shall endure for the remaining years of your life, and to God that he will make you his dual instrument for the accomplishment of his purpose. You're also making a commitment to your children. You haven't met them yet. That's fine. It's okay. Don't get worried. Both of you will be patient and understanding with them, as well as being a godly example for them. Now, the achievement of this purpose is no small thing. It will require appreciation of each other's abilities and virtues, forgiveness of each other's faults, if you find any, an unfailing devotion to each other's welfare and development. Now, when talking about marriage, we pretty quickly go to the topic of love, and that often goes to 1 Corinthians 13. If you've ever been to a wedding, you have heard 1 Corinthians 13. But I want to try to encourage you open yourself up to it. Just because you've heard it before doesn't mean there's nothing new in it for you today. It says, love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects. It always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. That's powerful. What's even more amazing is that it shows us a glimpse of God. Scripture tells us God is love. Remember, not God does love, or love is something God may demonstrate from time to time. No. God is literally love. So since God is love, and love is kind, God is kind. Since God is love and love is patient, it reminds us that God is patient with us. When it says that love keeps no record of wrongs, oof, God keeps no record of our wrongs. That's good news, somebody. That is good news. The Bible says God is faithful to remember our sins no more. It says they are removed as far as the east is from the west. That is good news. Lastly, it says love never fails. And if God is love, that means God never fails. It might feel like it from time to time. If that's where you are right now today in the crowd or up here, I want to urge you to hold on and realize God may not be done yet. When Jesus was hanging on the cross, it sure didn't look like winning. But God was not done yet. So hold on. God is love, and love never fails. Now, love is what God is made of, but Genesis points to how we've been made. It says we've been made from each other. And after explaining that a bit, it says, that's why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, so they shall become one flesh. They become one flesh. Yes. What a beautiful word picture for marriage. Becoming one is indeed what brings us together today. Yeah. As many of you know, and most of you can imagine, we don't just accidentally have a great marriage. It takes determination. It takes us being intentional. After all, 1 John 3:18 says, let us not love with words or speech, but with action and in truth. With that in mind, I want to encourage you, wake up every day and ask yourself, how can I love my spouse better today? Encourage each other to create a fertile environment that's safe. Safe for honesty, safe for forgiveness, safe for truth and grace to permeate and grow to be the defining characteristics of your marriage. I want to encourage you to create a culture between the two of you where there's no place for grudges, lasting offense, deceit, selfishness, a whole host of other things that rob your joy and erode your relationship. Tough times will come. Hear me when I say this. Tough times will come. So prepare now so that your first instinct will be to draw towards each other, to lean towards each other, as opposed to viewing each other as another obstacle to overcome in the midst of those tough times. The Bible tells us that we are to love our spouses as Christ loved the church, even to the point where he laid down his life for him. Now, we may never have to physically lay down our lives for our partners, but we certainly have more than our opportunity to lay down our lives metaphorically. Any testimonies out there? When you put her needs above yours and you put his above your own, you can abandon selfishness and get your needs met. I want to also encourage you to take seriously what Scripture says about husbands and wives submitting to each other out of reverence for Christ. Think about that. Challenge yourself to live in a way that makes it easy and wise for your spouse to submit to you. When you are both looking for ways to grow in wisdom, and you're both looking for ways to serve each other better, and you're both looking for ways to invest in your partner, amazing things can and will happen. With that in mind, conduct yourselves in a way that makes it easy for your spouse to submit to you and wise for them to do so. And I honestly believe that you will add so much value to your marriage by doing that. Lastly, I want to encourage you not to look to the other to meet needs that they cannot meet. Justin, Jordan cannot be capable of being your everything. Likewise, Justin is not capable of being your everything. It is impossible. No one can be responsible for someone else's happiness or self-worth or a whole host of other things like that. When we expect our partners to meet those needs, we create some deeply unhealthy relationship dynamics, and we will crumble under the weight of that. When you feel yourself starting to get impatient or frustrated with the other, ask yourself, am I expecting my partner to provide something that they cannot possibly provide? Then adjust accordingly. Be honest with yourself and each other. Choose to grow in wisdom. Guard your expectations. And forgive quickly when expectations don't get met. And I believe your relationship, marriage, and life will be exponentially better than you both can imagine. You guys ready? Here we go. Justin, I'm going to ask you a few questions, and if it all sounds good to you, please respond by saying, I do. Do you, Justin, now take Jordan and choose her alone from all the world to be your wedded wife and to live together in holy matrimony? Will you give yourself to her? Will you share completely with her in your life together? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and cherish her in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Yes, sir. That's a good start. Now, Ms. Jordan, I'm going to ask you a few questions, and if it all sounds good to you, please respond with an emphatically wonderful, I do. Come on, make it echo. In the same way to you, Jordan, now take Justin, choosing him alone from all the world to be your wedded husband and to live together in holy matrimony. Will you give yourself to him? Will you share completely with him in your life together? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and cherish him in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Come on. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Justin, please repeat after me. I, Justin. Strong start. That's good. Take you, Jordan. To be my wife. Yes, sir. To have and to hold. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. Yes, sir. To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
To protect and honor. Till death do us part. According to God's holy law. This is my solemn vow. You did better than me. I didn't make it through, and my wife laughed at me. So that's already better than me. I made it to I, Josh, and that was it. And she just laughed. So, Miss Jordan, please repeat after me. I, Jordan.
Take you, Justin.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better or for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. To protect and to honor.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
Oof, good job. May I have the rings? It's at the pawn shop, isn't it? There you go. Perfect. Justin, please place the ring on Jordan's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol.
I give you my name and all that I am.
I will love you and care for you. Yes, sir. I seal the vows I have made to you. In the name of the Father. And the Son. And the Holy Spirit. Wonderful. Ms. Jordan, please place the ring on Justin's finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring as a symbol. I gladly take your name. I give you myself.
And all that I am.
I will love you and care for you. I seal the vows I have made to you. In the name of the Father.
And the Son.
And the Holy Spirit. Well done. Inasmuch as you have consented together in holy matrimony and have before God and these fine witnesses committed your lives to each other and exchanged vows and rings. By the power vested in me, it is with exceeding joy that I pronounce you as husband and wife. You may kiss your spouse. Now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Why don't you turn to your amazing witnesses. It is with great joy I present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Justin Gabel.
Without a worry or care, you stole my heart right here. gone by. I wish I could recapture all those times. It goes by so fast before you realize there's a woman standing there before your eyes. Now on the dance floor on your wedding day, tears in my eyes, so much more to say. So dance, dance, this is a dance. So dance, dance, this is our dance. So dance, dance, this is our dance. Dance with me, my love. This is
you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world a warmth and your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want. And you please save it, you only stay smart.
Thank you for this food, but Lord, we thank you for Justin. Lord, we thank you for Jordan. Lord, we pray for more of every good and perfect thing you have for them. Lord, more peace, more unity. Lord, more favor, more health, more wellness. Lord, we pray that no matter how amazing the marriages are that they've seen, Lord, that their marriage is better than that. And then as they bring children into the mix, their children have a better marriage than even they do. Lord, we pray for wise friends to surround them, Lord. Not friends that'll take sides, not friends that'll help them fight better, but that will help them fight for each other. Lord, as some have said, being stubborn is only bad if you're wrong. So Lord, help them be stubborn about the good things, about the right things. Help them make sure they are right before they are stubborn. Lord, so that they can hold on with steadfastness to what is true and what will serve them so well. Lord, if there's anything that anyone has said to them today, no matter how well-meaning, that is not of you, I ask that you filter it on out. Lord, just because we are all sincere does not mean we are right. We can be sincerely wrong. So Lord, leave Justin and Jordan only with the encouragement you want them to be left with. We love you. In your son's name we pray. All God's people said,
amen.
Amen.
I just keep. On the count of three, one. My man got a beard. Two.
Into the future, it's as far.